Hello everyone, and let's check out another exciting chess game from the chess history. And in this chess game, white is Karl Mayet, and his opponent is Johannes Zukertort, the super aggressive chess player from the 19th century and one of the rivals of Wilhelm Steinitz. And this game was played in Berlin in 1868. So Karl Mayet starts the game with playing e4, e5 by Zukertort. And we have King's Gambit accepted, Bishop to c4, d5, sacrificing the pawn, e takes on d5, and Queen to h4 by Zukertort, that's check, King to f1, and losing the castling rights, Bishop to d6, Knight to f3, defending the Queen, d4, Zukertort played Knight to e7, Bishop to b5, check, blocking, and exchanging the bishops, c4. And white has a strong center. But white's pawn structure has been damaged, and Zukertort castled. And on the other hand, white can't castle. And that's one of the downsides of white. King to f2. And white wants to castle manually. But Zukertort played c5. D takes on c4, en passant. Knight takes pawn, c5. Defending the bishop, b4. Knight from d to e5 by Zukertort. The pawn is pinned, so if pawn takes knight, rook takes queen. This is why Mayet played g3, and then knight takes on f3. And in this position, Mayet didn't capture the knight, because if capturing the knight, white is losing, and he played d5, advancing with the pawns. Actually, the pawn is pinned. Let's take it back. If queen takes on f3, then knight takes on d4, and this is losing for white. If king takes on f3, this is even worse. Then knight takes on d4, with check, king to g2, and queen to c6. And again, white is losing. So we have d5, and knight takes on h2, capturing another pawn, d6. Advancing, f takes on g3, check, king to g2, and queen to f6, by Zukertort, bishop to e3, and bishop takes on d6, sacrificing the piece. In order to free his position, bishop takes on d6, c takes on d6, and then rook takes on d6, attacking the queen, blocking, and also defending the rook. Because black could always capture the rook. But then doubling the rooks by Zukertort. Another very strong attack by Zukertort. Karl Mayet played king takes on g3, attacking the knight. But then Zukertort captured on d2. Rook takes on d2 by Zukertort. The exchange sacrifice, attacking the queen. So bishop takes on d2. And it looks like still white is attacking the knight. What would you do? Well, Zukertort played rook to d3. That's check. Not defending the knight, but attacking. We have king to g2. Well, this is like a beautiful puzzle. What would you do? If capturing the knight with the king, then queen to f2. Checkmate. So after rook to d3, we have king to g2. But then queen to g6. Check. Where is the king going? King to f2, and then queen to g3, by Zukertort, check. Defending the king again, and queen to f3, by Johannes Zukertort, and white resigns. What a game. Another super exciting, and a very aggressive chess game, by Johannes Zukertort. And let me show you the possible continuation. Why did Karl Mayet resign? At this moment of the game, because he is getting checkmated, there is forced checkmate. If defending the king, then queen takes on h1, check. Let's say king to e2, and queen to f3, king to e1, and queen to f1, checkmate. After queen takes on h1, let's say king to f2, then rook to f3, and again, white is getting checkmated, just like this. A fantastic checkmate. What a beautiful chess game by Zukertort. Another aggression in the chessboard. So this is why, after queen to f3, white resigned. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care, and bye-bye.